Hi guys, and welcome to this first section on the series of tutorials about AutoHotkey for beginners. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to work with variables. If you are already a programmer, you might be already familiar with this topic, but I recommend you to watch it anyways because AutoHotkey treats the variables in a slightly different ways than other programming languages, so you might find some useful information in here. Now, if you are not a programmer, then let's see how we can set up a variable. In AutoHotkey, we have two ways of doing that. We can use the equal sign to assign the value to a variable name, or we can use the colon equals operand that we will see in a few seconds. So, quick notes in here. AutoHotkey is not case sensitive, which means that you can use uppercases and lowercases to refer to a variable. Also, you do not need to initialize a variable. Also, you do not need to specify what kind of information you're storing on that variable. In some programming languages, like for example C or C++, sometimes you need to specify if you're storing an integer or a character or a string. In this case, if you're using specifically the equal sign, you don't need to do anything. You just put whatever you want to put in that variable and that's it. And the reason is because this particular method stores everything which is on the right side of the equal sign as a string of text. So those numbers that you see in there, the 1, the 5 plus 5, they're all stored as text. And to illustrate that, I'm going to use the message box command on the last variable, that is the emix string, which contains this is another string and 5 plus 5. If I print that using the message box, what I'm going to get is this is another string, 5 plus 5, exactly as I typed it. Now, I'm going to show you what the difference is when you're using the other operand, which is the colon equals sign. In this case, the process is similar. You just put the variable name on the left side, the colon equals sign in the middle, and then the information that you want to store on the right side. But in here, what is happening is that what you're storing in that particular variable is actually the result of an expression. So everything which is on the right side of the colon equals sign is an expression. And for that reason, you need to enclose strings of text within quotation marks. Because if you don't do that, the expression is going to see that text as a variable name. And later on, we will see what that means. So in this particular case, 5 plus 5, as you can see in the third example, it is not going to be stored as 5 plus 5. What the expression is going to do is that it's going to perform the mathematical operation of 5 plus 5, and it is going to store the number 10 in that particular variable. So I'm going to print the last variable, which contains a string of text and the operation 5 plus 5, but as you can see, that 5 plus 5 is outside of the string because it is after the quotation marks. So when I print that, what I'm going to get is this is a string 10, because as I mentioned before, what is being stored in that particular variable is actually the result of the operations. Now let's see how we can get the data out of a variable. One thing that you are going to do very often is store the contents of a variable into another variable. So in this particular case, the first example, we're using retrieve1 as a new variable, and we are storing the information that is inside the variable called exp1. So we're getting that information out of exp1 and putting it on retrieve1. And sometimes you want to do that, for example, when you are working with a clipboard and you want to save the information that was in the clipboard into another variable, work on the information that you want, you know, work on the clipboard, delete it, or, you know, put something new. And then after you finished working whatever you wanted, then you put the information that was stored in there before back. So it is kind of, you can do that, and you will see some cases in which you might want to do that, or you might want to store the results of a variable into another one. And when using the equal sign, as I mentioned before, everything on the right side is treated as a string of text. So you need to differentiate the name of a variable from a normal string of text. And for that, you need to put the percent signs around it. And on the other hand, when you're using the colon equals operand, as I mentioned, everything is on the right side is treated as an expression, and within expressions, any text that it is not enclosed in quotation marks is treated as a variable name. So for that reason, if I want to assign The information that is stored in the variable called exp2 to the variable retrieve2, then I don't need to put any signs around the variable name. So I wanted to mention those two things because later on you will see that there are some commands that expect expressions, and there are some other commands that what they expect are strings. So this information will become very useful later on. Now, before we enter into that, let's see the common errors while assigning variables. And this is something that you might say, well, those errors are so stupid, they are so obvious and stuff. But after you're coding for a long time, then you might make one of them. And this particular section, I just want to make you aware of those errors so you can know where to start looking for errors when your script is not working. So your script is not working. Well, start by checking if your variables are assigned correctly or not. So let's see the first example. And here we have the variable called eexp1, and I want to assign the result of 5 plus 5. Then you say, duh, of course, you're using the equal sign. Yes, you're using the equal sign, and usually what you need to do is store the results of an expression is to use the colon equal sign. So this is very simple, but it can happen. If you use the colon equal sign all the time, one day you might be too quick and do not put the colon and you just leave the equals, and then you are expecting the result 10 stored in your variable, but you're getting this. And when you're getting that, or you know, your script is not going to work fine, then you might want to take a look to see if your variable is being assigned correctly. If you assign it correctly, you're going to get the number 10, which is what you wanted to do, no? So on the other hand, we have the second example in here, in which I'm trying to store a string of text into the variable e string 1, but I'm using the colon equal sign. And in this particular case, what is going to happen is something very interesting. If you print that into the screen, you're going to get nothing. And what is happening is that AutoHotkey is treating those words as variable names. As I mentioned, everything on an expression that is not quoted is a variable name. So AutoHotkey is trying to get the information out of the variable called I, then is trying to get the information from the variable called want, and so on, and there's nothing in there because they're not created. AutoHotkey is not going to give you an error. Your variable is going to come up, it is going to come empty. So you need to be aware of that, because sometimes you're expecting that your script is going to perform some operations on this variable, but that variable is empty, and it is just simply because the text that you stored does not have quotation marks. So the correct way of fixing that is using the quotation marks around the text, and then when you print that particular variable on the screen, it's going to come up normal. Now, there is another common error that we make from time to time. Of course, I make those mistakes too. Even though I know the errors, sometimes, as I mentioned, you're too quick. You can make the mistake at any point. It is, for example, you're trying to store the information from the variable called eexp1 into the variable called eretrieve1, but you're using the equal sign, and you're not putting percent signs around it. So basically, that is going to come up as a text, a string of text, and you know that the correct way of doing that is using the percent signs around when you're using the equal sign. And I wanted to show you this particular